Hello, hello, hello. Today is Tuesday, September 3, 2024. You follow the solutions to problem 210. When I announced it, I said this is a difficult problem. Well, at least 20 people have the right answer, so it wasn't all that difficult as I thought. Originally, Keith Norman and Eugen and I decided this to be problem 198. But we all three thought it was kind of difficult. I was not the only one. And so we delayed it, and we made it 210. And when you see Keith Norman's video solution very shortly, you will see that he marks at the very top that it was originally 198. So, if you're ready, I'm ready.
This is Keith's solution to Walter Lewin's problem 198. It concerns a simple circuit with a capacitor, an inductor, and two resistors. And for a given input voltage, which varies, and we're actually given the formulae for the two varying voltages that we need to consider, we're asked to calculate the potential difference between point A and point B. And we're also told that R1, R2 equals L over C. Okay, now I was all set to calculate the current through there, work out the potential difference, a potential drop across here and across here, and then work out what the potential difference is across there. Totally unnecessary. So after a little bit of thought, I wrote the answer down, and here is the answer. For part A, the potential difference across A and B is zero. It's also zero for part B. And in fact, for any varying or any input voltage at all, it's always going to be zero across A and B. So how did I manage to do that and save myself a lot of tedious arithmetic? Okay, Walter Lewin likes to do art quizzes. And there are some little nuggets of good advice in his art quizzes, and one of the bits of advice was art is about a new way of seeing. And this he said in his art quiz, it was actually number 55, concerning the fountain. Okay, so let's think about a new way of seeing. If I redraw this circuit here, I can make it look like that. It's exactly the same circuit, I've just rearranged these two arms a little bit. And I think if you saw that to start with, you'd immediately think that looks a bit like a Wheatstone bridge. Except we have a capacitor and an inductor. Historically it would have been four resistors, but the principle still applies to any impedance. So the condition at balance, where the potential difference across A and B would be zero, is true when we get that the ratio of this impedance to that is the same as the ratio of that impedance to that, this condition here. So when I saw that, I could immediately say, this condition is met. Simply, here we have, rearranged that. And if you've looked at Walter Lewin's rather good, rather excellent lecture 25 of 802, we can see R1, R2 equals 1 over omega C times 1 over omega times omega L, and that cancels down to L over C, independent of omega. And I'm considering the modulus, the size of the impedances there. I ought also to consider the phase angle, just to be doubly sure I'm not pulling a fast one on anybody. We can see that if I consider two currents, there is a difference in phase of these two currents, which would be this expression here. I'm just subtracting one arctangent from another. Again, he discusses this in lecture 25. And if I throw that into the mathematical formula for the difference of two arctangents, I can show that it again is independent of omega, and it's actually 90 degrees. Pi by 2 is the difference between those two currents. So you're going to say, okay, there's a 90 degree difference. That's on the currents. Do remember that across one of these, we will get a further 90 degree or pi by 2 phase shift. So I can actually say that the voltages at A and B are in phase. They do satisfy this balance condition. Thank you.